today. It's had a one of Aaron's Amazon returns got returned. I was trying to figure out, does Amazon not exist anymore? Because to me, when you buy something from Amazon, regardless of what is that last thing called? What's the .com, the .net?
Oh, CCTLD.
Cool, I thought there was a name for it, not an acronym.
Country code, top level domain.
Oh, top, it's the domain code, okay.
It's a top level domain.
Okay. Whatever, but it's like that little extension. It's the extension. The file name in the extension.
Yes.
It's the extension. That's what I'm talking about. Regardless of what your Amazon ends in, they all get mailed back to Amazon. But his shirt was fulfilled through a third party? No.
Yeah.
Sold by a third party, fulfilled by Amazon.
Yes.
Okay. So the shirt was the wrong size.
My fault. It was my fault. I ordered X large, but I'm in Europe.
Yeah. Anyways, and so he asked to replace it, and the guy's like, sure. Here's your mailing label. Postage was paid and all that stuff?
No.
Oh, lovely. I guess that's your... Oh, was that what we took to...
Yeah.
That's what we took to... I didn't realize because I was so crazy getting ready for vacation. The day before we left, we went by Primera and shipped something off.
Yeah.
For some reason, I thought we were shipping to Kathy or Mom or your parents or something. I'm like, I don't know. So we shipped it off and we just now got it back. And so why did we get it back?
Recipient not located, no forwarding address, return to sender.
Yeah.
So apparently the address on the shipping label provided by the
sender
wasn't right.
Or they moved in the process because international shipping takes a long time.
Yeah.
I mean, so, like, you contacted him, he sent the label, you know, a week went by, and that was at the beginning of September, or at the end of August.
Yeah.
Then things get there.
And honestly, I had the label sitting in my backpack for a while.
Oh. Regardless, a month crossed.
Yeah.
So... maybe the lease was up, or the person had to move their house, or they weren't in their thing anymore. But the thing is he ordered it from Amazon DE and had to ship it back to the United States.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't like the way this light makes my face tan look right now. You see in the thing how I'm, like, not quite looking right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that Trumpy orange going on. But only because of the blinds. When I'm actually out and about and, like, outside, you know, not closed up indoors, I look relatively okay. I've seen it from various other videos.
You can't wait!
Alright, we're at McDonald's. Aaron finally got soft serve for first time in...
Not all that long, but...
Okay, I think he kept trying to get it on the cruise, but they never really had the machine for it. Yeah. It's 50 cents ice cream from McDonald's. Yeah. I'm not expecting it to be Tillamook
but
Creamery.
It's exactly what I want.
Exactly. Yeah. And I got the thingy that Aaron can try later, but we're gonna eat the old, I think we've had the old Dutch before, but they're basically bacon cheeseburgers.
With old Dutch cheese.
Old Amsterdam, but yeah.
Yeah. Dad says, I want to get a gazebo. Son says, yeah, but who's going to take care of the gazebo? Not me.
He's trying to tell me a joke, and it's not a third-party joke. I would call
it's
a
third-hand.
It's a reverse joke, also. It's a really weird sense of humor. Thanks, Bird.
Yeah.
Hi. Yeah. But it's sort of like me going onto Facebook posts that, like, ABC News puts out of, like, deadly car accidents, and all I say is, this is why we need to ban cars. We need to just put licenses on everything. Just take it away. I have a or, like, whatever. As I start utilizing the gun debate for other things. And like, but as he was saying, it was sort of like the dads are always like, yeah, well, who's going to feed the dog? Who's going to take care of the dog?
Yeah.
So the kid throws the excuse back at the dad. Yeah. We're at Oyster Park. There's a lady with a harp up there. Very interesting. She probably was playing at the gazebo, which spawned
that whole thing.
Yeah. And I was like, oh, someone's barbecuing. But it's a nice day. It's going to be like 21, 22 out.
Yeah.
We're gonna go eat later at Burritos Anonymous because those burritos are just so damn good.
Mm, should we talk about the McD's food?
You can.
Yeah, it was just a burger.
It was a burger, had old Amsterdam cheese on it, and
a little bit of a kick.
The spicy pimento sauce was like zingy mayo.
Yeah.
It was creamy, but with a little bit of zing to it, but not like overly spicy. Not like capsaicin. Alright, I've started tagging. They're all uploaded. And I had to like, because they uploaded, I put them all up in mass. It wasn't necessarily the order I clicked on them. I don't know why. It makes sense. All the vacation videos are uploaded, but they're uploaded in a weird order because they uploaded like smallest to biggest.
Oh, you don't even know, need to go to the gym with that thing.
All Sunday.
And I'm just terrible at tagging, like putting the actual like search tags in it, because like Athens is gonna be cool because I can put in basically just keep typing Greek gods, you know, and I could type in various different things of like Athens and how to spell Athens and maybe even get like the Greek name for Athens in Greek, but it's just like I don't know what to do for Brindisi. But yeah, with like the departure video, it was like, okay, that's pretty cool. And I'd put the tags in it for like the various things that I think I saw out the window. And then like the name of the cruise line, the name of the boat, and like stuff. And then when we went, and then I also did Brindisi, but I was like, what do I do?
Yeah.
Brindisi, statue, water, nobody's awake. Like, and to be fair, a lot of it's explained in the video as to why, and it's actually really cool. But,
yeah.
I don't know when I'm going to make these public. Obviously, Patreon's going to get something. But then it's sort of like, do I just burst them all, like, make them unlisted now for Patreon, hold on to it for a week, put them all out later, and just have people like, oh my god, he just uploaded 8 videos in one day. Not really, but sure.
All right. So, they didn't have ghost pepper today. They gave me, how about the next one down? Because that's all they had for their burritos. But, they gave me a little bit. Let's turn that bottle a little bit. Yeah. And that's it right there on my burrito. So, yeah. It's just easier to record on the phone.
Hoily, 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 hoy. So yeah, that... Aaron has seen me eat spicy stuff and I've never... He thinks I was pushing my limit.
I think you may have been.
See, now we could go down Dapper Mark. Not have anything in our way.
Yeah.
And yeah, you guys might be able to hear that. Apparently, Briar Eye Hentai is having a live music for its bar patrons. Like,
yeah.
Like, it was to the point where I was like, maybe we should go by and have a beer. Like, because it just seemed like a really fun and happening place. But I'm like, no. I can't see straight right now. Like I read something to Aaron about a slow-cooked rib chuck burrito. And he's like, yeah, I saw that after I ordered my burrito. To be fair, he has no remorse about his burrito because he saw this one second. Like, I honestly think even the vegetarian burrito would be up Aaron's alley.
Yeah.
Like...
The veggie burrito has corn in it.
Well, that too. But that's the thing is, like, it's... I love Burritos Anonymous, but the thing is they didn't have their, as I said in the video, they didn't, and I'm coming stupid right now, is they didn't have their thing, so he brought out, because he heard me say that, I was just like, whatever you got is the spiciest. So he brought out the 89% Trinidad Scorpion. And I knew I should be cautious with that. Because I've seen the videos and I've done my research. I even did it right there in the restaurant.
Yeah.
And was like, we're looking at borderline 2 million Scoville units, top end.
Yeah, that is hot by anyone's standards.
Considering a habanero is about capped out at 355,000. Yeah.
Chipotle Scoville.
He's looking that up while I talk. And so, it's just... But I was, like, I made the little... too big a bite, but it had shocked my throat so much, my throat started swelling a little bit. So that's why I was eating the burrito really fast. Well, it because at first I thought it was too big a bite, but then I realized after I swallowed, it was like my throat then relaxed and realized it's not that bad, which is why I kind of put my tongue on some sour cream. Yeah, I ate 2 cups of sour cream. I ate those 2 cups. And I'm still, my nose was running down my mouth like I was having snotty burrito. Like I had an experience with Trinidad Scorpion. And 89%, you might, it's just like, they say 89% because they have to put water and vinegar in there. But we also found out that they have kind of a sambal bajak. It's called Scared Elephant. And he suspects... The reason why it's called Scared Elephant is because they'll take the chipotle, they'll take the peppers, and they'll put them on the top of the fence, and it'll keep the elephants away, because they don't like the spicy.
I can't blame them. I just looked up chipotles. So yours tops out at 2 million. Mine tops out at 8,000.
Yeah, and as you guys have, as I just said, habanero can go up to the mid-300,000s. Which is still hundreds of times more powerful than Aaron eats. Yeah.
And it wasn't enough.
And habanero wasn't enough for me. And we went higher. Like, there are a few others, like the California Reaper is like the one that's way up there, and I think it's borderline 5 million Scoville units. But I think that's literally, it's like, I think that's the one you have to handle with like rubber gloves, or you're gonna literally burn your fingers off.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's just only so much I may have found my limit somewhere in the upper millions of Scoville units, which is saying something.
The upper 1 million.
The upper 1 million, that's a better idea, better way to say that. Like the 1.5 to 2 million range is like, I don't want to have too much of it, but I can definitely handle it, which is saying something.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's also, now it's sort of like, you just literally tried 1.5 million Scoville units. No wonder you were trying to go back in after practice with a broken collarbone. So we've had food experiences today. Aaron has experienced as much as he wants to experience with me. And the. So we're gonna go home. I'm gonna finish tagging the vidyas and stuff, and we are going to, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for football stuff. Aaron was going to go do Elfia stuff.
But it's really far away and no one else is going.
Yeah, because it's out near Eindhoven, so he's thinking like maybe he could go with his Eindhoven buddies.
But like, they all canceled.
Yeah, but they all canceled. So it's like, I don't want to go all the way out there by myself. And it's like a 4 hour, it's like an hour and a half.
It's an hour 40 to Eindhoven. It's an hour 40 to Eindhoven. Then another
hour
and a half or so.
On
hour,
a
2 hours.
Bus.
To the actual place, $25 to get in, and then it's the same amount of time back. It's like I'd be there for a couple hours
with 8 hours of travel.
And the biggest reason I wanted to go is because they have delicious meat.
Yeah, and that way you could get the full idea of what that stuff was and could maybe order it or figure it out.
But you can't buy it except at Elfia.
Well, we'll just have to go next year to the one near Utrecht. Or if it's not near Utrecht, I think it is. I think it's always at Castle de Haar.
Yeah, I think they have those two locations.
Yeah, it's at Castle de Haar. But anyways, tomorrow, football stuff. The Vetstride shirts will be there, so we will actually have game jerseys to promote the club. So yeah, catch you guys later.